This episode, plumbing tips from the field. By this week, John and I both had some plumbing jobs. Mm-hmm. Always got to love plumbing, Johnny. Anyway, we thought we would basically tell the stories so that y'all don't make the same mistakes that we made.
Welcome to the Handyman Pros Radio Show, home improvement and maintenance tips from the pros.
Thanks for listening to another edition of the Handyman Pros Radio Show, where our goal is to help save you time, money, and aggravation, John, aggravation on your home maintenance and repair. This edition is entitled Plumbing Tips from the Field, some things we've learned, boy, oh boy. And to help me explain, I'm here with my ever cheerful co-host and old buddy, John. Johnny,
yep.
Talk to me,
and
baby.
And learning more every day.
Learning more every day. You know, it's some of these things aren't necessarily that we don't know them. It's that we forgot them, and then we got the rude awakening of, oh, yeah, surprise, guess what, right, kind of thing.
Right.
On both of these, that's exactly what mine is. But we're going to explain the significance of them because it's like, oh, duh, you know, duh.
Yeah. Duh. Well, there's, you know, it seems what makes me mad sometimes is it's kind of a rookie mistake that I kind of knew better. But, you know.
No, in your case, you did know
that,
better.
Be that as it may, you know, especially for some of you, you know, homeowners and DIYers out there, hopefully you can learn from the things that Larry and I talk about here on the show.
It is our goal, by the way. All right, folks, before we jump into this, let's just please like and subscribe. Give us good reviews. It helps get the word out there. We're trying to spread the word of the Handyman Pros Radio Show. We hope you enjoy it. If you don't, send us an email, questions@handymanprosradioshow.com. You know, give us good reviews, like and subscribe. It helps the algorithms figure out what people are listening to and so forth and so on. Two, one other thing, I'm going to make this quick announcement. If you have ideas for content, please don't hesitate to send them out there, because send us a note. You know, again, it's questions@handymanprosradioshow.com, because we're all about answering questions for things that y'all want to listen to. So let us know. All right, Johnny, I want you to start, because you've actually, here's one thing I have to explain. John is better at taking pictures and shooting video than I am. For whatever reason, I have the stupid phone with me all the time and I never take pictures. And for this show, I wish I had, because John shot a video. And so he's going to show us this video, right, John?
Yeah, I'm going to show a video of a mistake. And I know that, you know, we can talk about it after the video, the video here that I'm going to show you. So, and here's the video. Okay, so this is a replacement mixer for a shower, and it's a Delta RP19804. So I took off the other one and I replaced this one, a new one, and it's a little bit different than the old one, and there was really no indicator of adjusting the temperature on it. And I know that some of these are adjusting. Listen, I replace these sometimes. I don't do it all the time like you plumbers out there, but you know, I forgot about this, and these things come adjusted lukewarm. So when you put them in, it would be really nice if Delta would have put something on the package that says adjust the temperature, because you know, you can walk away and you're stuck with a lukewarm shower, even though when you test it, you know, the water is getting warm. So you figure, okay, you know, here we go. So, I know that you got to go and take the temperature of these things, you know, with the water coming out, and you can adjust it that way per code and all that. But, I've replaced many different cartridges before that never had to do that. But, there are these cartridges that do. So anyways, just kind of a word to the folks out there, especially you homeowners that are going to replace these cartridges. So here's a short video clip that I did as well to kind of show you how to do that.
All right. So I just installed this cartridge and it's lukewarm. And I know that they have a temperature setting, but they come lukewarm. I wish the package would have said that. That would have been great, but it didn't. So we need to adjust this. Pull this out. Quarter turn. Put it back in. And let's see what happens. And yep, that did it. So, all right.
Okay, Larry, we're back.
All right. So, yeah, it was about 2 minutes long there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the point is, right, shower temperature cartridge or cartridge temperature of water coming into the shower cartridge, right? For whatever reason, they always set them at in that middle range. And this is true whether it's in this case, the one that John showed you basically does not have any gradations on it. Is that correct, John?
That's the way it looked to me, the new one. Now, the old one did.
Yes.
But the new one didn't, you know?
Yes.
And these kind of things can slip by you. Now, thank goodness this was right, you know, a few doors down.
So right.
Not a big deal, you know?
Because the upshot was what? You got a call back, right?
Right, right. It took me three minutes. But what was funny was, you know, I went into the internet, and the first thing that popped up was this Delta cartridge that comes set lukewarm. Now, I have replaced these cartridges before, like I said in the video, and I've never had a problem. You know, some of them, you know, there was no temperature setting. It was just, you know, just don't scald yourself. Now, I know due to code and everything now that, you know, they try to protect you from you, and you know, I think it's like, what, 120 degrees or something they set them at, you know, and you're supposed to run it into a bottle with a, you know, or into a container with a thermometer and, you know, and then you set it that way. Okay.
Most of the time your water temperature is set at the water heater as well. So it's kind of double redundancy in my opinion.
So here we go, right? You know, it's one of those things where, you know, I replaced it. I turned it on, like I said in the video, and the warm water starting to come out. I'm like, okay, well, we're good.
Yeah, you're good.
Well,
right?
You know, hey, I didn't take a shower in it though. So they, you know, lukewarm at best. But it took me all of 2 minutes, you know, to go back in there and take the handle off and just pull the temperature setting and turn it counterclockwise. So, you know, once again, learn from our mistakes. You know, if you're a homeowner and you're, you know, have never done this before, these things aren't that hard, especially the Delta. Now the Moens, you might need an extractor.
Yeah,
you know,
special
puller.
Tool. Yep.
But for the Deltas and things, they're pretty straightforward. But don't forget that crucial step.
Don't forget to turn the temperature up if it has that temperature on there. Yeah.
But
turn the temperature up.
Right. My point here was that I wish they would have put that on the package to a little bit more an outstanding word to the consumer.
Right.
You know, hey, you guys have to, there is nothing in there that, you know, blurts that out.
because as we always say, one of our biggest tips, or at least it's the biggest tip for me, is make sure you read the instructions before you go to do anything.
And I did.
Just read the instructions. Do yourself a favor. Read the instructions. I know manly men out there don't like to read instructions.
I looked this thing inside and out, and I'm like, because it was different than the original one.
Yep.
I'm like, oh, yep. Okay, well, maybe they just did away. You know, no. So anyway, save, you know, now for you handymen out there,
Don't get the call back. Oh my
right,
God. You know,
right. Like, and if you're talking about a half hour drive, so for me, it was, you know, a couple doors down, not a big deal, but so there's that. So Larry, you ran into some problems.
So this is the same thing. I had a job. It was, you know, person says, well, I need a faucet replaced. Right. And I'm like, oh, okay, that's not a big deal. You know, no biggie, right. It's not a big deal. Well, I didn't get any pictures or anything, and they had bought the faucet, the replacement faucet, which was fine. You know, generally all that's good. But just to kind of finish my story, it's in a pedestal sink. And I don't know how many of you, if you haven't done a pedestal sink, pretty tight up under a pedestal sink, especially for somebody with big hands. I have big hands. And it's tough to get wrenches and stuff under there. Anyway, long story short, pedestal, this particular was a three-piece. It was a three-piece faucet, right? So it had two knobs on each side that had their own valve in it, and a centerpiece. And then there's plumbing that ties the two together, you know, basically in a T-type fashion in between. And I think what I forgot when I looked at it was, I was like, oh, this is only going to take, you know, about an hour, right? Roughly about an hour. And I'm like, yeah, okay, no big deal. And I sort of did the bad thing of opened my mouth to the customer and said, oh, it's only going to take about an hour. Well, she comes on to check on me after an hour and I don't even have the first one apart, which is the second part of this story. But I was like, yeah, I forgot that there are a lot of pieces. I mean, there's three pieces that come up through the sink plus all the stuff that's underneath it. So instead of just having, say, two supply lines and two nuts like you do on a traditional sink, you know, this one didn't had a push down stopper. So it was really very simple on the drain side. But anyway, you know, where it's just two nuts basically, and that thing pops out and everything goes, you know, boom, boom, you take the supply lines off, boom, boom, you put the new one in, you're all done. No, this was, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parts that have to come apart before you can get the thing out. This was the other part that I'd forgotten, is that because it's seven parts, so two sides, the center section of the faucet and the one side of the faucet came out, piece of cake, no problems, put the wrenches on it.
Always the one.
And then the other one was corroded, and it took an act of God. Yeah. I was about to go get the Sawzall, literally about to go get the Sawzall to cut the thing off. And I said, I'm just going to try it one more time. And it popped. And I was so thankful because, folks, if you don't know this, cutting something off a sink is really difficult because you can damage the sink. Yeah. You got to be super, super careful. Yeah. And anyway,
let me put a plug in for you folks out there. If you're going to do this kind of stuff, go get yourself a strap wrench if you can.
Too. Yes. Yeah.
So just while I'm thinking of that, because I just used mine the other day.
The good news on this one was I wasn't trying to save the old faucet pieces in any way whatsoever. They were almost 20 years old. And so it was like, yeah, this is past its service life. You know, there's no recycling. Yeah. This is going in the trash can is what it was. So I didn't really care if I damaged it. But if you are trying to salvage anything or whatever, yeah, strap wrench is the way to go. You know, and if you don't know what a strap wrench is, just look it up. It's really a good thing. Anyway, the point of this, the other thing that I had forgotten is pedestal sinks are, I said this earlier, but they're really tight up underneath. Yep. And it's tough to get a wrench or anything up in there. And they do, usually they mount a little bit differently. Some of these, they mount from the top most of the time. So just be aware of that. When you get into one of these, this is one of the times that say, go to YouTube and actually look up just a thing on the particular brand that you're taking off, because each brand is different. This particular one was an American Standard, and I knew how to take an American Standard off because I put them in before. So I knew the steps involved. Sometimes if you're looking at it and saying, how do I get this off? Do a quick Google search and just check it and just look at how it actually comes off, because different brands are different. Moen is a very different mounting system than American Standard, which is probably different than Delta as well. So those are the tips. I mean, they seem simple. Johnny, have you done any of those pedestal sink ones?
I've done a bunch of them.
Yep.
I've done a bunch of them because when all the homes went in here, everybody had a pedestal sink. So mm-hmm. I've been either replacing the faucets on those pedestals or I've replaced the pedestal sink altogether. They're coming back from a design perspective, but they are a little bit tricky. Now, if the most of the faucets that I've done have been mounted through the top. So if you can get the top off, the retaining rings, then they fall through.
Right.
But they are pretty tight underneath. The one thing to know about pedestal sinks, folks, is that most of those pedestal sinks, the pedestal's there to cover the plumbing. The sink is usually attached to walls, not sitting on the pedestals.
Right.
Per se.
Yep.
But, you know, if you can move that pedestal out of there so you can get to all that plumbing.
Makes the job a lot easier.
Yeah. But if you,
on this job could not get the pedestal out. I tried and yeah. it was going to damage the wall.
Right. Right. It was I've seen them silicone to the wall. I've seen just all kinds of stuff, you know. So
this one wasn't that. It was the sink was attached to the wall that it wasn't right. I needed to lift it up just a hair and yep. I'm not going to force an issue that's going to create a different problem, right?
Right. Right. So that's the thing. So, you know, folks, now I will tell you the other thing. And I'm going to put a plug in for, buy good faucets. If you're going to do all this, buy good faucets.
Absolutely.
Because I just went through this past week. I just went through some faucets that I'm not going to mention the manufacturer. I really don't care for the manufacturer, but they actually had plastic seats in them. you know, for the valves themselves. Mm-hmm. And those things can get distorted. And no mm-hmm. matter what you do, they're just never going to seal up correct. You know, you put new cartridges in, it's just, you know, just buy decent faucets. You know, you don't have to buy top of the line faucets, but you know, buy decent brand name type faucets and you'll be much happier in the long run.
Yeah. We go over that time and time again on all the products. Buy at least a middle grade product. Don't go for the least expensive thing. And, you know, be careful with the bells and whistles on some of this stuff, because it just adds a level of complication that might be good or it might be bad, but generally it's not, it's another maintenance item is what it is.
You know, just from the other plumbing perspective here is that, you know, I just replaced some things at a customer's house that I have worked on time and time. It's
a recurring issue.
These things just were problems. One of them was a toilet, and it was just awful the way that it was designed. It was the kind of toilet that you flush it. You had to pull up this knob in the middle of the tank. You know, on the water tank instead of a lever. And the kids were always screwing that thing up, you know. It was just a mess. And then they had another sink issue on like a pedestal. That was one of those bowl sinks.
Oh, yes.
It was just awful. So at the end of the day here, the end of the story was, he's like, yeah, I'm kind of done with that. I said, you know what? Now is the time. Let's just do all new parts, everything, you know. So, and here we are. The whole powder room is all redone, and everything's working great. And he's got some solid products in there now. So, just my bias towards buying decent stuff.
Well, the thing is, and think about it this way, folks. You know, if you don't know, I'm kind of a numbers guy. You pay a little bit of extra money now, but you get a tremendously much longer service life and less back. Look, folks, save time, money, and aggravation. It's much less aggravating. It really is. Don't set yourself up for aggravation. Why? It's just these are things you don't need to think about. It needs to work. It just needs to work. You use these every single day. And your things you use every single, this is my opinion, but if you use it every single day, do it right and do it once, you know, and just do yourself a favor. Oh,
right. The other thing was that some of these things were really hard to keep clean too. So it's just, you know, you got to make these considerations, all around when you buy these faucets or
fixtures,
toilets,
basically.
Or fixtures, you know, whatever, fixtures. What have you. So that's my take, Larry.
That's
my take. And I got to do a pedestal sink, probably next week. So
Johnny's going to be saying,
I'll let you know.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I know one of them already is absolutely, stuck, rusted shut on one of the, I think it's the cold side. So yeah, it should be fun.
Yeah, it's really now, it's something else. It's
the last time I left it, I did spray it down with some WD-40. So hopefully by the time I get back there, it'll loosen up a little bit. So
that, or a little PB blaster, right? PB blaster is always good. Knock it into the
rust shotgun
or a sawzall.
Yes. So
all right, well, Johnny. Did you do any faucet repairs in the spaceship? Have you done any of those?
No,
yet?
Sir. No,
have you
sir.
Found a faucet when you took a spaceship apart? I guess that's a different question, right?
Yeah, I don't even know if they have them in there, to tell you the truth. It's weird.
Yeah.
They got some weird plumbing in those things.
I wonder, you know, like back in the old days when they used to flush out
of the
airplanes.
That's what they said about your plumbing, Larry. All right.
We Johnny, can't go there, right, buddy. All right, folks, if you like this craziness called the Handyman Pros Radio Show, please send us an email, questions@HandymanProsRadioShow. Like and subscribe to our channels. It does help get the word out there. And with that, I don't know, Johnny, take us home, baby.
Well, folks, thanks for listening. Don't forget to give us a 5-star review and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And have a great week. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time on the Handyman Pros Radio Show.